phoenixes turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Vega squadrons turn to ban. Phoenixes turn to pick.
Shadow Fiend.
Vega squadrons turn to pick. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Bang.
Vega squadrons turn to pick.
Dark Seer.
Phoenixes turn to pick.
Spirit Breaker.
Phoenixes turn to ban. Vega squadrons turn to ban. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Phoenixes turn to ban. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Vega squadrons turn to ban. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Vega squadrons turn to pick.
Of pain.
Phoenixes turn to pick.
Dazzle! Ancient apparition.
Phoenixes turn to pick. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Takiro.
Vega squadrons turn to ban. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Phoenixes turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Vega squadrons turn to pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Wraith King!
Phoenixes turn to pick. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
clinks.
Vega, if you are in a Zupu chat,
yep,
give us a toof.
Yep.
So we know that you guys, this is for technical feedback, you know?
Or tooth pride.
Or tooth pride. Or winter face.
Tooth pride.
Or winter face. Anything works. And we have a pause, so, you know, we're not missing anything.
Yep.
I don't know if you need to turn off your BTS. Your BTS HUD.
Yep. I it's probably too late. We're in. We're committed. I don't know.
No, you need to turn off your BTS HUD. You sell
okay,
out.
Okay. Just chill.
No, you don't need to do it. Do you even know how to turn off HUDs?
Oh, there
you go.
Here?
You hit default. Bottom. There you go.
Default.
Yeah.
It lied. I thought I was in default, but it turns out.
Right.
All right. So we're not. This is not the BTS HUD. We're in the default. What's cracking? MVP. They've gone for Jakira again. Do you think this is just an MVP? I mean, obviously it's an MVP thing, but is this here legit? OG pick it, so it must be legit.
They have stopped picking it, too.
Okay. So, if OG stopped picking it, then here are not good.
Not good.
Not worth.
I mean, you were very surprised. I remember casting that one game in the studio where they lost a fight at the enemy tier 1. And then Jakiro just pushed down like a lane of Rex.
Yeah.
So like only Jakiro could really do things like that. So I think the hero's pretty good. The downside is obviously where if one of your lanes is having a rough time, he can't really be that support that rotate like Wyvern, Bane, or Dazzle to help out.
I mean, does Dazzle really, like, he doesn't rotate. He rotates to maybe, like, save people. He doesn't really rotate for ganks or kills.
Right. Jakiro does nothing of that nature.
Okay.
Like, he actually says, I need to sit in the safe lane and sap experience.
And the build we normally see is Dual Breath, Liquid Fire. So you don't even have, like, a let's TP in an ice path to hit them with a stun. So.
All right. So we got three viewers replying with Tooth, What Face, and whatever else. Thank you.
Tooth Brides? I don't know.
No Tooth Brides. I'm not sure it's a command. What about the Clinks, dude? We're not even in this game, you know? We're too focused on Tinder and stuff.
Don't get me started on that. MP kind of mixing things up with the Clinks pick, and I think a lot of like MVP's previous tour over Vega was just like the surprise factor, the aggression coming out. Mm-hmm. That one was more early game oriented with IO Spirit Breaker. This time they again have Spirit Breaker, but they're going to pair it with Clinks, who takes a
How
bit
surprised
to come online.
Would they be if the courier gets sniped?
I don't know. I can't see him right now.
All right.
They should be pretty surprised.
Yep.
I was surprised. I wasn't ready to catch it until you had my back.
Yeah, that's why.
It's because I got these icons. I don't know about these icons on the minimap. I much prefer the dots.
Oh, you have the names normally?
I do the dots, and then when you push alt, the names pop up.
Oh, okay. All right. Fair enough. It's okay. I'll try my best to help you out. The big difference in this game is that we have a somewhat of a lane swap, and Clinks normally just wrecks Darkseer, right? There's really nothing Darkseer could do in this lane.
1v1, not so much, but yeah, with the Jakiro, absolutely. This is going to be a tough lane for Mag, and Clink should have a very good time. You can't really easily take out the Iron Shell creep, though, so Darkseer should still be able to at least get some farm. But, I mean, the interesting thing is more to me, like, both teams running their kind of farming carries on the off lane. Like, it just seems to become the safer lane for teams to be putting their core heroes nowadays.
Yep. Both of the carries will get farmed, like you said, but I think the more important trade-off is that Spearbreaker is getting relatively safe levels, and if he rotates to push a lane, for example, or to gank a lane, excuse me, he's not really worried about his tower going down.
Yeah.
Whereas if Darkseer, like, you know, goes away for a minute, maybe jungling, Liquid Fire plus Searing Arrow on your towers, you're going to take some significant T1 damage.
And Spearbreaker is very much, like, up here to get levels. He doesn't really care about getting some farm, whereas
exactly.
Darkseer needs to get farm to really do Darkseer things. You can't actually play this hero just with levels and no farm whatsoever. He's got to farm his mech and transition to a blink, whatever it may be, so.
Right. The big thing I remember in the first MVP game was, you remember the Spearbreaker plus the Bounty Hunter, where the Shadow Fiend was really forced to front line, and he died every fight. I think having a Dazzle in this game would really help out. Mid lane looks like, the charge going to get Hansel solo as well as Forev in a little bit of a duel.
Yeah.
But nothing comes of it.
I think you just actually want to just check out the rune as well there, so realize the AA had already snagged it and won't get it for himself.
Oh. Salve on the mid lane getting cancelled by the Fiend's Grim. Or not Fiend's Grim.
The Haste Rune causing problems. QO misses one raise and... I gotta say, QO's had a bad day so far. He got trashed by PyCat.
Yeah.
Which is not what I would have expected in that 1v1 matchup. But
solo kill too.
Yeah, absolutely. No, it was Windranger versus TA, which is, what, very early levels, maybe slightly Windranger favored, and then it gets more even slash TA favored a bit later on, but... it was the very early levels where PyCat just played it really well.
Yep. And this game, not having the bottle is resulting in him really losing on the farm.
He's manning up and fighting. I think he realizes he's not going to be able to get out. He's going to long range soon. He goes
down. Yep. So, wow. Again, you know, getting solo killed. Although, to be fair, if the short rays actually hit no one, he wins that trade. Yep. Short range, the short rays barely just out of range.
And the other big problem was Dubu was off checking the jungle to stack. His stack's actually been blocked. I think that was when Dubu just found out that it was blocked, and he wasn't there for the Shadow Wave. If he has Shadow Wave there, he's also fine. He didn't actually need that much more HP to be able to run away.
So, the overall result of that trade is I'm surprised he went for it when his Zazzle is not there.
For the SF,
yeah,
I think he had no option to run. Perhaps he'd just get kited down, or he'd take.
I don't know. I think he could have turned
and just hightailed it out of there.
Yeah, but you know,
it's hard because like you know, Quap's gonna get a couple more right clicks off on you, and at best he gets away on like 50 HP. Then he has to walk to found, and then he has to TP out. So I guess just fighting, manning up, and then if you die, you TP back to lane.
Oh, forever. Might actually have the ice set in on the top lane. He will. But his tier 1's gonna take a ton of damage. In fact, 4 range creeps stacked up back in the river here. Dubu trying to fight out against 2 heroes. He's in a grave, no TP, so he's definitely dead for there.
Yeah. Itemless Dazzle. Okay, buys a TP and OMS.
Okay. Top lane though, T1 is actually gonna go down here. I did not expect this lane to push this one.
I mean, you talk about doing a flame cast, Lumi. I gotta start flaming you, man. What happened to the T1 tower not going down to an AA Wraith King lane?
Did you expect this tower to die?
I don't know. I didn't make any bold claims. Like, dude, this tower's not going anywhere.
There's 5 range creeps. They freaking like stagger the creep wave by pulling to the right.
That's actually impressive how you get 5 range creeps in a side lane at this stage of the game. It's like when you get the perfect creep equilibrium and you get the double siege creep. That's my favorite. Like back when it used to be all about like controlling the lane and keeping your offlane as level 1, and you'd get the double siege creep versus double siege creep. It was a thing of beauty, but yeah, this what happened up here?
Yeah. I think he did do the equilibrium thing for a bit, like you said. You double up on the range creep. Maybe you pulled to the right on the big camp, and then it tripled up with the next wave, and I guess the 4th and 5th came later, so...
Yeah.
Forev is gonna get a ton of levels.
I mean, he's gonna get levels anyways, like, I guess, so you're not really gonna zone out a Spirit Breaker with this lane.
Okay. How are they gonna get this skill? Well, no ice bath.
With bashes. Just
one more?
He's got another charge in 5 seconds, he's just gonna go for the bashes now, okay. I don't think Ice Bath does much. It's pretty, like, what? Level 1 is, 1 second duration, yeah. So...
So, with most Klink's lineup, once he gets level 6 or 7, he could start being active.
You've got to, as well. Not a hero you pick to just sit there and farm with. That's the SF more, who's going to be farming while Klink tries to create space. Speaking of that mid lane matchup, no one going aggressive once more. He's skipped his ulti at level 6. Used to see this a bit, but haven't seen it in a while, I want to say.
I'm not a fan of skipping it. Bottom lane looks like we're going to see a little bit of dive here. Klings went down to what I imagine a dust game. In fact, they're going to turn it around here again. Wall's going to get dropped down. Riz is going to take a stun as well. The level 4 Jakiro is not going to survive through this.
Damn.
Queen of Pain, Sonic Wave, not needed.
This is really bad start for MVP. This is nothing's going right. I don't know. Like the one lane that started off okay for them, the Klinks versus the Darkseer, has quickly gone south now as well.
Yep. So I made a bold prediction that MVP is going to 2-0 Vega. So far, not looking good.
Yep. It's really not. This game one is pretty ugly. We're just, 7 minutes in, so 4k gold lead. Experience, much less, but that's experience, and it's pretty hard to get a really big XP lead early on. They're looking for their first kill, which should be a freebie on solo, so...
Alright,
that's like
that
the... classic support takes over a lane to get his level 6 and then you decide to gank him because you're so far behind he's the only kill on the map you can get. It's like you see that happen and it's like, yeah, MVP got a kill, but realistically, when that's the only kill on the map you can get, you, like, it's not really a good position to be in.
I mean, it's better than nothing.
Yeah, yeah, you still take it.
You can't go on the Rift King, you can't go on the Queen of Pain.
You have to take it. If you don't take it, then you're playing your bad situation even worse. Like, they're playing the bad situation they're in, like, as best as can be, but
yep.
It doesn't change the fact they're kind of getting owned here.
Yeah, they are getting owned, but to be fair, I think their MVP lineup kind of comes online maybe in 5-6 minutes. And I'm talking about the timing with the Shadow Fiend mech. Speaking of Shadow Fiend mech, he's in a lot of trouble here on the right side. Kyo is gonna die to that Sonic Wave. Meanwhile, up on top lane here, Solo gonna die. No, he's not even gonna die here. Just tanky enough to survive with 10 HP, and he's Gucci.
Yeah.
For F though.
Okay, he goes down. Meanwhile, No one lurking around as well. So yeah, they lose a couple, and Forb was going really aggressive in there from behind. Ay, ay, ay. Losing the SF. I was watching Solo try and die again. I didn't see the SF, but I heard the Sonic Wave, so... That was very reminiscent of the previous game, where it's like, you die and then you just TP back. Well, in the PL's case for Pasha, it was like he walked back and then just died again, but Solo somehow managed to escape.
He's teleporting into mid. What they don't know is that charge is coming in, and there is no Sonic Wave, so maybe they actually get a return kill on Sioma. Sioma, very low, the tower shot, not gonna get the kill. Charge is not on him, so...
Yeah. And even if it was, I don't think 4-Up could have gone for it.
Wow, they're actually going in for this. Ultimate's gonna come through here against Solo. I thought it should have been on Queen of Pain. I think you get the kill there.
Yeah. And for Vega, they just got a bit complacent, not recognizing the charge coming, because they could have easily backed off further, but they were trying to do the TP bottle refill, so...
Yeah.
If not for the TP bottle refill, Vega would have just backed off behind the tower and been fine, so... It's the MVP aggression. This is their way back in this game, is to keep being aggressive. They can't play farming like a farming style here, and Klinks with the medallion already picked up is going to look to continue to apply pressure.
Yeah, so I was trying to touch on the timing thing earlier, which is the Shadow Fiend mech, your Jakiro getting like level 7-8 where you can start using liquid fire on towers. And since they're on the dire side, especially with the early medallion on Klinks, you can start looking Roshan as a comeback point as well. I don't think MVP is completely out of it, but let's be real, they're really disadvantaged. Rave King is getting absolute free farm. In fact, he's going to be going Blaymail first, and I imagine probably Blink Dagger afterwards. But the key thing for Rave King normally is actually hitting level 11, and he's getting to do that without even needing to die the first time.
Dude, it's all about that Radiance timing, man, nowadays.
Radiance timing. Who actually builds Radiance?
Almost Rave Kings do.
After, I mean, like, in my pub games, they definitely do.
Blade Mail Radiance, it's the build. Maybe like a blink in there, possibly, but...
I think only Envy does...
No, we'll see a Radiance this game.
Alright, we'll see. Ryzen,
I'll put money on Radiance. I'll buy you dinner if there's no Radiance.
I mean, you don't have cash, right?
Shout out to Baclaris who shout out my dinner last night, although I'm paying back. Yeah. There we go. Alright, Daxi gets sniped. This is what they gotta do. Keep finding these pickoffs. They do lose the tier 1 tower while that was going on. And Wraith King does have money for the Blade Mail now if he wants it.
Yeah, let's be real, they're not really defending these towers, so... If you could trade tower for kills right now, I think you should take the trade if you're MVP.
Yeah, that's a Darkseid kill. You slow down the mech. The mech is actually a pretty scary timing, because that's when Vega can really take anything on the map, and MVP get a tower of their own. Qo gets mid. A more important tower for the most part.
Alright, Forev is gonna charge across. He doesn't have his... Oh no, he does have his ultimate, but he canceled the charge. I guess this ganking duel is really nice as well. The Klinks plus.
No one at top. Don't think his stun will come in fast enough here. It's a long TP.
Yeah, I really like this ganking duel, the Klinks Spiritbreaker, because you don't really know that you're being charged, and as soon as the charge hits, you're just dead.
And even when the Spiritbreaker doesn't get there in time, if you're trying to fog a Klinks, you can't do that when you're getting charged up, as Klinks will miss a kill here in the mid lane. He didn't have mana even for the Searing Arrows, but he's going to be fine. He's got plenty of HP with the Death Pack. Mag goes down to start things off. Solo's still lurking around. Won't get the Cold Feet proc, and Daxia pays the price there. It was actually the AA they went on with the Klinks, and Daxia just kind of getting a bit too confident there that he'll be fine.
He did buy the mech recipe before he died, though, so that's kind of the most...
Nah, he had that. He had that already. He had when he died last time, he had that mech recipe. So
okay,
he
just died twice
money in
a row.
Yeah.
And
he's struggling. This is a slow, steady kind of turnaround. MVP turn a 5k gold lead into a 3k one. And you kind of talked about this was going to be their timing window, something coming soon, and yeah, the Spirit Breaker plus Klinks a big part of that.
I think given the start being down by only 3k is actually them at being ahead. I don't know what that race is trying to get, but
Yeah,
more on the fact that they're on the Dire side, they got the Klings, they got the Roshan, and speaking of Roshan, looks like we're gonna see a fight near that Sioma. It's gonna try to get off that grip, but Ice Blast, this could be big. It's gonna hit on everybody. Sonic Wave on top as well. Kyo trying to get off his ultimate, but looks like he needs to rechannel again. He will definitely die here. Let's see how much can they get out of this. In fact, I think they're gonna get the raping again. Ice Path is gonna hit. There's gonna be a dual breath as well. MP trying to do as much damage on the backline as possible.
Ash just got another blade mail though. I don't think you want to really fight into him. The Darkseer now shows up, gets the stun onto the Spirit Breaker, and Pasha will turn things around. MVP overcommitting there. Just, I mean, this is that first big reincarnation. Yeah, it's now on cooldown for 4 minutes time, but it wins you a fight like that. That's well worth it.
Yeah. Do you feel like if it was a different carry, like something that's not a Klinks, that they would have done better there?
Yes, Klinks does not want to 5v5 in at this stage of the game.
Well, if you 5v5, you're looking to more pick off a quick support kill, you know?
Let's say that's a gyrocopter. that's the obvious, like, we're not even the best teamfight hero, like, the most commonly picked carry nowadays.
Fair
like,
enough.
Let's say it was a Jug, maybe. Jug, not quite as good as gyro.
Jug would have been excellent there.
Yeah, exactly. Klinks. No, like, as far as carries go in that situation, probably like bottom 20% to have in that situation. But he's great for the pick. Everything that was happening before that, where they kept finding pickups, that's what Klinks wants to be doing.
Yep. And I think what Vega was expecting with that smoke towards the Roshan is to catch MVP doing the Roshan, because this would be a very good timing for MVP to sneak one.
Yeah.
I guess lucky for MVP that they weren't doing that, because that teamfight would have been worse.
Oh, yeah. So MP grabs a creep. Walks up again, and we'll keep looking for those snipes. And MVP have good wards to go with this, which is kind of important to try and find pickoffs.
Mm-hmm. The mech comes online now, so despite the repeated kills against him, Millane, Ferev just charged through the hold. He's gonna get stunned here. Well, he gets Yules as well. I think he's definitely
that
dead.
That may have helped him a little bit. Now the Nether Strike will not push him out of the cold feet. Vacuum back. Ice Blast could catch everyone. Dubu and Ferev. Two who will go down. Four of that that grave not going to help you out. He's going to go for one last charge onto Solo. Won't even get the hit as it's been a 2-for-1 so far. Solo being chased down by Ryzen here. He gets to the higher ground. SF pops. And Vega just looking for the next kill here as it's going to be the Klinks.
No dust.
Okay, maybe should have gone for Ryzen on the Chikiro. And it looks like, well, they're going to get Ryzen anyways. Blink forward. Don't need the Sonic Wave, or do you? Okay, no, you don't.
So the second fight in a row where MVP gets caught in like a random river spot where Ice Blast and Vacuum both hits. Can't expect to win these fights or even come close in these fights. And we talked about the timing of the Darkseer mech being delayed. Where is the Shadow Fiend mech?
It's Yasha.
Yeah, I feel like this is the mech. I mean, sure, there's Ice Blast. But you don't... Oh, what a... Look at Sioma! He just drops a sentry in the middle of the ground, catches MP, but he can't get off the Nightmare because it's Bane nighttime.
Bane, by the way, level 5. I don't know how that's
Well, if you're Nightmares, they get the kill for sure.
Yeah. I'm just surprised he's level 5.
They see him.
He can't get past
but
it.
But there's no sentry. There's no dust.
Yeah, there goes sentry. Nightmare now.
Oh, but he walks into the sentry. But there's nobody there.
Corpse coming. Corpse
What's
TP.
Happening? No, he's going to be fine, right? No, they have Yules. They have Yules. Can they just use him?
He's still in sentry range, isn't he?
Okay,
that worked.
It's like
that was some
that was a Benny Hill music right there.
I mean, did MP really play that badly? I feel like he didn't really make any mistakes. It looks like he just like made all kinds of mistakes, but
I don't know about this game about MVP. Klinks is a very momentum-based hero, and he has no momentum.
It's 4-2-2, like, it was starting to look okay for him. Like, there was that tiny little downward swing on the graph, and, like, it was the two Darkseer pickoffs.
Yep. Alright, so I think you were gonna mention something about the Yasha versus mech on Shadow Fiend?
I don't know what I was gonna mention.
Oh, okay.
I was thinking about it, I wanted to try and back him up and be like, yeah, I think SMY, like, he's gonna carry, you know, the Klinks is creating space so SF can carry, but... You know Vega are gonna just five man and force fight, so
the thing is there is an Ice Blast, so get not getting the mech, but
yeah.
You can't expect Ice Blast to hit every time, even though he has so far.
And you just mech around the Ice Blast too. Until there's Nax, which doesn't come till much later, I think you still get value out of an SF mech against AA.
Dude, the mech for the armor, bro.
Yeah. So you were saying something about a Wraith King Radiance, by the way?
I see. I mean, when you're stopping so hard, you might as well.
No, it's actually like the build. I'm
like real talk.
Not trolling. Yeah, real talk.
Real talk. I think you want blink dagger for initiation, but you're winning so hard that it doesn't matter.
I think often you can go blink before the radiance, but I think radiance is very much a core item race game. All right. It's really good.
It definitely helped you farm.
Yep.
I mean, this game when you're so far ahead, when you have 2 lives, just walk in.
Yep. Well, okay. Usually you see, like, sometimes you go, like, the Maelstrom build or the Midas, but you can't really go Midas on carries anymore because your carries are meant to fight using their early levels and just their farm advantage, so you've got to go for, like, you got to spend, like, your first however much gold on either cheap cost-effective items. Like, you're a PL, you're a Gyro, you're buying, like, Rings of Aquila, Phase Boots, Treads, Drums. Wraith King, you're buying the Blade Metal Treads, so, with the wand. So you very much have to buy, like, the fighting items when you're a carry in the current metagame.
Speaking of cheap effective items, I really appreciate the Yule Scepter buy on the Queen of Pain. Because,
yeah,
multi-purpose, right? First, it protects yourself from Feref if he's trying to solo kill you, and maybe a little bit down the line when Klinx is also trying to solo kill you. But in this fight, in this game, as we see a fight breaking out, Kyo trying to line up that Requiem. Well, does get the immediate quick kill. He's gonna come back alive, and I'm not sure if you have enough to bring him a second time, especially after the mech. Huge vacuum wall onto 4 here. The ultimate's gonna fly off. They're gonna get 9 posh, and they're gonna walk out for free. Wow, they...
He didn't get the blame on the Requiem, I guess. I've seen that play before, and the blame on Requiem is what I was expecting to happen, yeah. As no one will find the Haze Rune MP, gets gripped up, Sonic Wave is at the ready, as well as a Scream here, no one. Gonna hold the Sonic Wave for now, gets the Scream off, could Sonic Wave onto a couple, Dubu's low on the higher ground, I'm not sure if no one sees that. Off to the side, it's Sioma trying to fight, Sonic Wave goes through, catches QO, they want the SF, and with it, oh, there we go, Queen of Pain, couple of right clicks, they will get it, 3-3 so far, they'll get one more in the Spirit Breaker. Dubu, TP, and... Okay, yep. He'll get out.
That ain't bad for MVP.
Yeah, it's, I imagine it was a game for them. No, okay, that doesn't show the Wraith King kill. I think with the Wraith King kill, it's probably an actual gold win, even though they lost 4-3. I think it was still probably at least either an even or a slightly advantageous fight.
I mean, I'm looking at the Shadow King gold where he finishes the Sanch or SMY, and he still has 1k left. I say that's...
How much? Oh, he got a lot of kills. He got AA, Bane, he got... I don't know who got the kill on the
but look Wraith at the net worth. He's actually ahead of the Wraith King, despite you know, the terrible start, so... I was talking about the Yules. I think this game, if Shadow Fiend cannot channel Requiem before the fight, like, really develops, they can't win the fight.
Yeah.
So Yules is also very good for that.
He got it so early. It's not bad against Klinx as well. Like, you see him start right-clicking with Strafe, you throw him up in the air, and then that Strafe duration is largely wasted. Klinx... We already talked, he's bad at fighting in general, and if you take Strafe out of the picture, he's terrible at fighting, so... you have to really be... Like, just from playing a lot of Klinx, like, you have to really be careful about your timing when you fight. Like, I'm constantly, like, on mic when I'm playing this hero, like, don't fight, wait 10 seconds till I have a Death Pact, or wait 10 seconds till my Strafe comes back up, because you're so reliant on these two spells to be able to fight. They both have really low cooldowns, but they also have short uptime.
Yep. Charge happening on the bottom lane. We're gonna see an ultimate being dropped down. Can they kill him quickly enough before he mechs? Looks like not, as he's gonna try to search himself out, but great raises coming out here from the Shadow Fiend. Feref gonna die, suicide TP out, and Kyo trying to get a right click kill.
Oh, he's just going in with an SMY. Kyo is feeling confident.
Back in the jungle, looks like MP gets caught out here by the Wraith King.
Oh, Kyo needs to be careful. He's got the Dazzle. Dubu's just going to frontline and say, take me instead. And no one's not having it. He's going to turn around, kill Dubu while throwing the Yules onto Kyo. Really sick play coming out of no one. They've got not got the Requiem cancel, but doesn't look like it's going to matter. Kyo trying to take one with him. Will do so. But not really worth it.
Top lane.
Does this work, Ryzen? Okay. Tower goes down. Pasha can't really stun as the Jakira will just TP out, so... He's just up here to get some farm.
I'm not sure if I like the fights that MVP are choosing to take. Mm. Like under the enemy tier 1.
Yeah, Kyo was literally just running under the tier 1 tower like he's not going to put anything he's scared of in the world right now, which considering you're down 13 kills, probably should not be the case.
Yep.
Not like he had his BKB. If he had BKB SMY, maybe it's a different story, but...
I mean, is there a silver lining that we're missing out here? Maybe talking about the fact that Jakiro is getting fairly farmed?
They've got to get Deso and sneak Roche. I don't think it's so much like a late game silver lining. I think it's more about there are some plays they can make to get back in the game. If they get a Roche with the Deso Klinx, some big team fights like when SF gets BKB.
And Wraith King late game
like,
it's not bad.
You can get kited. Yeah, it's definitely not bad. And I'm pretty sure he'll go for like the blink next. I think that's what, like, you mentioned, like Envy, like his kind of build, Radiance blink with right. the blade mill.
Yes, he could get kited, but not long enough where the yeah. rest of Vega can't drop their spells. I think that's a problem.
It's actually not great kiting as well. There's no four stops. There's just a Jakiro really to kite. I guess SF with SMY can kind of poke and prod a bit.
Jakiro is amazing actually against Wraith King though.
Yeah. I mean, you get blink BKB is probably like blink BKB AC and then you're fine though.
Yeah.
Blinks yeah. is actually not going for Deso. He's going BKB, which.
All right.
I don't know. It's okay. I get that he needs it this game. Oh.
Ryzen tanks one. In fact, though, they're gonna get a trade. I think any trade you could get right now for MVP, you're happy. But can they make it out? That's a question. Maybe they could go fight another one and get a Queen of Pain kill. But you gotta get the hell out of there and quick. MP running to the right side. Dubu says, just take me, man. TP out. No Yule Scepter for this one. MP gets home scot free.
Yeah. Bane used up his mind, didn't have a grip, so. 2-for-1. I mean, do you still say worth for MVP there when it's 2-for-1? Maybe
if,
not.
If Shadow Fiend was hitting the tier 2 top,
yeah, it's worth farming, it. I guess. And he is hitting the tier 2 now.
QO, I think, wanted to help his team and he kind of walked halfway across the map and was like, oh, wait, I can't get through this fight. So I think RTZ would have been hitting the tier 2 and maybe taking it by now. But, QO confirmed not RTZ.
Well, Darkseid comes in. QO too late for a Requiem windup, but he's just gonna. I mean, this is like classic QO. Like, your team's behind.
He has
behind.
A BKB TP, so he knows he can make this yeah. play, but.
Well, he's gonna have to do so now. The Ice Blast, a couple of right clicks could cause some problems, but there's nothing yeah. anywhere nearby.
There's a charge coming in. I can't see.
And is that worth your 10 second BKB?
Oh, probably. Speaking of mech, I'm completely. Like, did not catch the Whoa. Fact that Spirit Breaker has a mech.
Huh.
What do you think about this? I mean, Shadow Fiend doesn't have to buy one, so that's great, I guess.
I think it's really questionable.
Is it though, like, how much mana are you gonna actually spend in a fight?
Is this really an item you want on a Spirit Breaker, though?
Is he actually gonna be able to
I mean,
get
is this really an item you... I feel like, did they need to go for a mech, period, with the SF not getting one?
I think mech is very necessary against the way that Vega fights. So I agree with the mech, having a mech. I'm not sure what I agree with it, Sparebreaker getting yeah. one, but...
I mean, Jakiro would not have found one, and Jakiro needs a Yule Scepter.
I mean,
no matter
you know
what
about
Winter
Jakiro not
you.
Getting mech.
Look,
look, we lost that pop game because you didn't get mech, and also I sucked on Leshrac.
Look,
but you were equal in the game
you,
losing.
You can't farm in Jakiro if you go like mech first. Like that's like the end of your item progression. The Yules helps you farm because you can get the mana regen for it. And you actually have a terrible mana pool because you go Trinkles on this hero. You don't go Arcane Boots. You can't go straight mech on Jakiro. It doesn't work.
Right, so Spirit Breaker you're getting the mech is excellent, right?
I just think they should have maybe skipped on the mech this game. If SF doesn't get one, which I think is like the... I think the debates, does SF go mech? And that's like a, well, situational, but I don't think anyone else should go mech.
Well, you know, as we see, looks like Vega just coming in for a gank. If he gets the Crimson Mech dual combo, that's pretty nice, but he's probably going for BKB. He's
gotta probably, yeah, it looks like BKB game. And you want to make sure you're not getting the vacuum off on the Darkseer for the team fight.
Speaking of defensive items, I think Pipe has a place this game for MVP as well. Obviously, they can't afford it. I mean, just against the Radiance is nice.
Well, my thing with Pipe is always like, who's going to farm it? We'll see a charge in from 4, they get quickly cancelled.
Yeah. Kind of posturing around this tier 2, I think it's worth to try to defend this one, but it's going to be hard. QO does have that 9 second BKB.
This is just going to go down. They're just trying to delay it, I guess. I feel someone should be top, like the SF, farming and pushing. Yeah, or Klinks. Same story bottom lane. Klinks doesn't really want to fight. He's going for the BKB first, so... It is more of a fighting item, but...
I bet you that he started thinking of Deso, and I was like, oh wait, game's getting rough.
Yeah, I think this was probably the right move, but... It does limit their ability to take a Roche. Same time they go for Roche and they get caught there, lose a fight, give away an Aegis, that is straight up game over.
Yep. You know, one thing that I didn't really consider about people buying mech, especially against Bane, is that Bane Finscript will take mana away from you, so...
Yeah.
There are situations where you just lose mana and cannot pop mech and things gets really badly.
I guess it depends if you're like, if you're not the Fiend's Grip target, which SB probably is not, but...
Ah, it depends.
He could be, yeah.
There's a double damage. I wonder if you see this and you're like, alright, let's go Rush.
It's been scouted. Radiant have vision of it though, so they'll
see
it.
Well, MVP doesn't know, right? Like, do you just grab DD and be like, all right, let's hope for the best?
Yeah, they may just get trounced here. QO, does he go for the DD? It's right beneath him. He picks it up. He's going to BKB and fight. Gets the DD on as well. The Bane's being taken out of. This looks really good for MVP suddenly. You've got a BKB double damage SF. He's just running forward, looking for more turns around the side. Still has a Requiem. He's not going to get a chance to wind up. What a team fight.
Well, it's not over just yet. Meanwhile, on the right side here, Ryzen chasing here against Solo. He should be able to get the kill. The problem is, what are you going to do for the Wraith King as he is...
He's pretty scary. Okay, you TP out and don't fight him. That's what you do.
All right, so ain't that bad. It's a fairly even trade.
Yes, and I mean, even trade favors MVP. 1,200 gold swing their way. Killing off no one's Queen of Pain. Big kill. That was a... Beyond Godlike streak going QO's way, although unfortunately he did end up dying.
Dude, he's got 3,800 gold. I think he's fine with it. What's the best item that you could get now?
Butterfly? Helm of the Dominator? I think like Helm of the Dominator Butterfly or Helm of the Dominator Crit. You get a helm, right? Like maybe less so against... I guess Satanic's not great later on against
Is Manta
AA.
Any good here? Like you could disassemble. Like maybe
Manta's
you dodge
no
a stun.
No. You're not getting out of amp damage. You're not against Jug. You're not against, like you're not like a silence target.
Yeah, I guess BKB does anything that Manta could do, but better.
You need to start thinking, like...
Taking damage? It's just
thinking of, like, what's,
of
like,
fights...
you're gonna, like, around four big items, like, what's your ideal four items to fight with? Like, is it Scotty Butterfly? Is it Lifesteal Butterfly? Is it Crit plus Butterfly? Like, to me, is more what you want to consider.
Alright, just chucks out Sonic Wave. I'm more focused on the fact that he's dying every fight. Like, I'm thinking if there's an item to remedy that.
And then Scotty. If you're worried about dying, I think Scotty's the answer.
I like Scotty as a suggestion. Like, you suddenly just become very tanky.
Yes.
And keep in mind that the more you tank for your Clinks, the more he could do in the fight as well.
Yep.
So, essentially, you're tanking for two heroes,
and
the way that this lineup works.
Dazzle Weave maybe means you've got some damage amplification coming from that.
Sure, yeah.
Looks like we'll find out soon. You're sending Curry to shop, but there's no poison orb on it, so it's probably Eagle Song.
Nice, sends it back.
Oh, okay. What you doing, SF? Helm Dominator, there we go, man. I told you, helm plus anything, you know? You got it, even against the AA, I think it's good. Like,
I
want Satanic late game on SF.
I wouldn't buy it just because there's an AA, at least not this early. I was thinking just raw stats is better, but...
Getting your Butterfly before Helm maybe makes more sense when there's an AA, but... It's such a good... Like, it gives you armor, like, armor damage, the stats from Helm is actually ridiculous.
I don't know about this charge for Evans in there right now. He needs to get out of there because he's going to get complete bash and stun. He pops a mech for himself. Meanwhile, on the south side of the fight here, no one fighting against QO BKB, but Ice Blast is being taken up on him. Meanwhile, Sonic Wave hits on QO. QO BKBs, he's going to die. Who's actually fighting the Rave King? We got one kill on the Rave King. I mean, it's not going to be enough here as one by one, the MVP lineup just gets murdered.
How about that Spirit Breaker mech? And he's charging it again.
Dude, he mech'd himself.
That was just bad initiation. That was not the play. He got like trapped in the Roche pit by himself, 1v1 against Wraith King, and Wraith King loves that.
And
fight.
Roche was hitting him too.
No, that. I think they could have looked to take the fight, but it needed to go down a different way. Find a charge on someone else. Like if you can charge through the Wraith King and then catch the back lines. But there's so many ways to cancel that charge, so it's unlikely to work.
Alright, so this is very interesting from QO. He buys a blink next. So he's not looking to...
That's surely... What is
this? I
mean,
there's a Radiance on your side, right? Like,
what is this blink? Is this like a split-pushing blink? Like you see someone TP in to try and gank you when you're split-pushing?
I think he's looking to fight with that blink.
And you get a better BKB Rec Room off with this, because you can blink in.
Not sold.
I'm not sold. I think it's... it's questionable. No one with a nice heals cancels the charge, and they'll blow up for him. And... probably blow their chances in game one with this Spirit Breaker mech / SF Blink. I don't know.
My bold prediction of a 2-0 MVP is just that, just a bold prediction, because I think Vega's going to take game one.
Yep, it's looking that way. They're not going to tap out just yet. They've got an SF with tons of farm, and that's probably what Q is saying. Like, he sees their item, he's like, oh, I'm just as farmed as Wraith. I'm just as farmed as Qual.
Except he's got 4k on bad items.
Yeah. I think that the helm's okay if he could have it with the butterfly, but he couldn't even get like a helm plus Eagle Song.
Dude, how many right clicks is he getting off in the fight? I don't know if helm's good. I'm not so.
I'm not even. Maybe it's a crit game as well. I think crit would have been quite good this game.
Well,
God, this blink was definitely like I don't know.
We'll ask Kiro later.
Yeah, exactly. I'm happy actually, to flip you up.
He's actually rooming right across from me.
Nice.
So I'll knock on the door tonight.
He's the kind of guy you can just like question or flame, and he'll like laugh about it, and like he won't take it personally.
Yeah, that's good to know.
Very approachable player.
All right. Okay, that's a pretty good start. Nice AOE, but you know you got three lives to go through here.
Is going through reincarnation really a good start? You get the AOE slow up, but now they're
okay.
Wide at the wreck. All right. No one.
He's life stealing.
He's got Aegis. He is life stealing. No, he's not actually. Not with the frostbite on him.
He's just gonna die on the back line. And with your Shadow Fiend dead, I mean, Klinx is also not doing anything in this fight.
I mean, 4F actually mech'd a couple heroes. That's good, right? MP? No, he doesn't even get Pasha. Okay, now he gets him. The sleep toggled off. MP with the BKB trying to find his way
through.
There's
so many Ghost Scepters. He actually doesn't do anything.
He actually had a decent amount of damage that fight. I think he used the Helm of the Dominator Death Pact to make sure he got a good Death Pact off, but that's that. Klinx buys back.
To see his Thraxus go down.
Yeah, but enjoy the scenery while you're here in Moscow.
All right. Well, at least the Russian crowd is having a good time seeing Vega win this game because as an MVP fan, this ain't great.
Yeah, it's not. It's been tough. QO gets solo killed mid again this time. Did lose it. Didn't have a courier for one thing, but it's it was still a solo kill. There was nothing much more to it. So,
yep.
If someone told me coming in today that one of the mid players is going to get solo killed in two games, I would not have expected to be QO.
Dude, everybody's getting solo killed. I think last game in the No One versus
Resolution.
Somebody solo killed. Yeah, Resolution got solo killed.
On the Invoker game or?